Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. Today we're playing some Raid Shadow Legends. This is going to be a spider dungeon guide. And happy Constitution Day to Norway, it's 17th of May of this recording, and yeah, so without any further ado. Also, by the way, I have a clan, Incredibles, Incredibles 2, Incredibles 3, Incredibles 4, maybe Incredibles 5 soon, so if you are dealing a lot to clan boss, you can apply to Incredibles ENCJ. You should contact me on Discord first or on Facebook, links in the description. Other than that, yeah, happy Constitution Day to people from Norway, and yeah, just decided to to add a little flag here and dress up a little bit as well. So, Spider Dungeon. This dungeon right here, in the very beginning, you guys probably remember the recordings if you've seen that long. I struggled a lot, like I spent a minute, yeah, as you can see here, a minute 14 seconds on stage 2, for example. Like, Spider has given me a lot of issues, but I've kind of gotten around to understanding it. And I've gotten a lot of help from a lot of people, like Pirate, Just a Guy, I think, even has. Yeah, like, a lot of people have been giving me advice, and I want to share that with you guys as well. So, what makes for a good Spider team? Like, how do you do this at an efficient rate? First of all, how it works is, you can see it's 8, 8, 8, 10, 10, 10. 12, 12, 12, 12. It's basically, I think it gives around, at the same stamina, for example, stage 6 and 7, they have the same likelihood of items, except for after they grade up. But as you can see here, for example, 12 stamina and 12 stamina, 3 to 5, these have the same chances of dropping the same starred items and the same type of items. Same goes for the 14 stamina, like this gives the same as this and as the 14 and 15. It's just differentiating between the type of boss it is. So if you have a team which is like mine, a blue team, then you can grind the green one. But if you have like the purple one, is kind of, yeah, it's neutral. And who is strong towards blue? If you have a red team, you can grind this blue one. But to my understanding, these drop the same rewards. I obviously think, I of course think that it's going to be more difficult down the road here. But I think as it costs the same stamina, it gives the same rewards. So now, how do you do that? How do you beat it in a short amount of time before the spider just heals back up again and you're screwed? And yeah, heals 100,000 and then you're dealing 50,000 and you're getting nowhere. So the key point to that is using a lot of AoE hitters, which means area of effect, which means they hit all the enemies at the same time. So getting, for example, a Ray would be fantastic for this, because you can see attacks all enemies, attacks all enemies, attacks all enemies. And that's very useful. So if you get a lot of AoE heroes, like I've Ray, I've Kayle doing AoE, I've Atel doing AoE, even though she only does it not too often, but still, these are all area of effect heroes, which will help you a lot. Of course, it's useful to have debuffers, not saying you need a Tomb Lord, but if you have a nice debuffer, like, for example, heal reduction, I'll give you guys an example of that. For example, Coltart. Coltart is a good hero for heal reduction. You can just put her and focus her on the spider, and then the spider cannot heal, and then you technically should be fine. I think the heal reduction should trigger on the spider if you have enough accuracy. So there's a lot of ways of doing this. A very useful way to do it. You need to have this autoable, which means you don't want to sit for hours doing the skills manually. I'll give you guys an example while doing it to show you guys how the AoE does things and how it helps you. So this is my Ray, Atel, and Kayle. All these are doing AoE. It's of course useful to have an attack buffer for your AoE hitters and an enemy debuffer, or even just buffing yourself even more. That's totally up to you how you want to do it. And it's also very important. It's useful to have speed aura in dungeons as well, because that means you may be able to hit the spider twice before he manages to do a skill. So now I have it not on auto. And as you can see, it's already going pretty slowly, like the spider is doing things in between. I have to do this as well to decrease their attack and defense. Then I have to do this. And it's just very slow. It's already been 22 seconds. If you want this to be useful, like, you don't want to sit here doing skills manually. As you can see, it's not really working out. It is working out, but it's already been a 35 second battle. As you can see with auto, I've already done it in a minute 10 seconds or something, and we're already approaching that. So if you do it on auto mode, it may not always make the right decisions. It may sometimes use wrong skills, but you just have to make do with that, which is why it's also, see that 127k heal, which is why it's important to do that. Another thing, when you're playing, you can focus on the spider by just clicking on it. Then all your heroes, of course, AoE heroes will still do AoE attacks, but all your other heroes will just focus on the spider alone, and that may help kill the boss quicker. I personally have not done that, but it's definitely something you can do to hopefully take the spider out. But yeah, AoE skills should still happen. You should still be fine. Please, Kale, do your AoE stuff. I don't think it makes the hero neglect AoE skills. That would really surprise me if it did. I don't think so. Yeah, 140k hits to the spider. And we're already going quite fast. And as you can see with poison from Kale, if you have a Kale, he's very useful, and I'd definitely recommend 6-starring him. Especially for things like this. He's just poisoning them a lot, and there we go, we took him out. And that's purely because we didn't let the spider heal, because Kale did a lot of AoE damage. Ray did, like, a lot of it, as you can see. Aethel did a lot. So if you get a main hitter to be able, a main area of effect hitter for Spider Dungeon, you should be very set. That's, for example, yeah, as I said, Kale, Aethel. You can have Elhane is also an AoE hitter. She actually does a lot for AoE. Especially in Spider. As for gear, it doesn't really matter, because of my team is a little bit stronger. But if you really do struggle to survive, I would definitely suggest using lifesteal with, of course, an attack percentage chest plate. I would use always crit rate gauntlets, and I would not spit on my monitor, because that's what I do sometimes. And I wouldn't use speed boots. Well, it's depends, because speed is very good for dungeons, and if you're able to hit twice before the enemy. So yeah, if you have a 5-star speed boots versus a 5-star attack percentage boots, I guess you could go for the attack percentage, as long as your support, which either gives you attack or a debuffer which reduces the enemy defense, they should potentially have speed, so that your main hitter, when she gets to hit, he or she, then she will deal a lot of damage. Because attack boots would, of course, help a lot with attack. As you can see, I would only get... Yeah, but that's just because I'm getting... I just get a lot of attack from my items, which is another thing. But yeah, I definitely recommend using lifesteal, especially early on. And you just have to repeat it a lot, because the banners... It's a very low drop chance. You will most likely get rings or necklaces. Especially in the beginning, if you're at stage 4, for example, you will most likely only get rings, and necklaces will be a rare drop. And then as you get further, there is a higher likelihood of getting necklaces and banners, but the banners are still very slow. I don't get a lot of them. Yeah, so that's basically how you do. So yeah, I would simply just get a main hitter, AoE damager, which would be strong to the enemy faction. Red would be green, a green strong enemy hitter. Or for green, a blue strong enemy hitter. For purple, it's kind of... Ech. I would rather focus on someone I'm strong against. And a red AoE damager for blue spider. And if you do that, you should do fine. And the more the merrier. As you can see, I have 3 area of effect stealers, and I have 2 support heroes. I could put in my apothecary and increase my speed even more. Maybe it would help, maybe it would not help. I seriously don't think it would help, because this guy is just... He's no freaking AoE damager, he's just a support hero. Which I also buffed. I got him a resistance banner, and I got him some more speed. So now he has 244 speed. I got him a more speed on the shield. Yeah, anyway, that's kind of off topic, but I made him strong again. Okay, good. Anyway, yeah, so I would much rather use Aethel for AoE, Kayle for AoE, and Rey for AoE. And if you have an all AoE damage dealer, then it's great. Rey is all AoE, and that makes her an SS quality hero, which is insanely, it's godlike. On the tier list on the Reddit, which does seem to fit a lot of the criteria. It does seem to be correct, the list, and that's also linked in my description on the under hero tier list on the top, in the top. So that's just something to keep in mind. And yeah, even if you don't have good heroes, if you have a good AoE hero, don't neglect it unless it's a horrible one. That's also why I would wanna recommend you to watch that list, whether it's good or not, because then it would show you, oh, it's bad against Fire Knight, it's great against Spider, it's alright in campaign. It's kind of good in Clan Boss, it's weak in Arena, and then you can just decide there whether your hero is worth upgrading or not. But that's basically what the Spider is. It's basically just get a lot of AoE hitters, fight the enemies they're strong against, whether it's green, red, blue, purple is eh. And other than that, I think that's about it. Like there's nothing more to the Spider. It's just that. But I would want you. I do recommend you to focus purely on just making it automatically doable. Don't strive towards doing everything manually. You don't want to sit and manually click skills for hours if you're grinding it that much. Anyway, I would like to thank everyone for watching. If you guys did enjoy, leave a like, subscribe. Happy Constitution Day, join my Discord, and join my clans if you deal a lot to Clan Boss, and that's about it. Goodbye.